Hello, welcome back in LADALIDI's tutorial. In today's video, I'm gonna show you how to create this skeuomorphic UI design. You don't need any 3D software to create this 3D volume controller. All you need is only Adobe Illustrator. In this previous video, I have shown you how to create this 3D button by adding a detailed texture. I hope you to watch it first before watching this one. Because in this video, I will show you how to create additional details. Click the link on the card or you can find it in the description box. First, we're gonna create a volume controller with detail indicator lines like this. Then the volume indicator by using numbers. After that, I'm gonna show you how to create a slider version of the volume controller using the metal buttons that we were created earlier. An equalizer slider like this. So, don't skip the video and watch it till the end. Without any further ado, let's jump into Adobe Illustrator. As usual, I have prepared a document with the size of 1920 by 1080 pixels. First, create the background. Use the rectangle tool to create a background with the same size as the artboard. Give it a gradient color with the same color as the previous video. Open the gradient panel. Then click the gradient annotator to apply this gradient to the background. Change the angle to 90 degrees. Click the color stop on the left, activate the color picker below, and pick a color in the color palette. Do the same for other color stop. Once done, go to the object menu. Lock and selection. Because this button has been created in previous video, so I just have to copy it. Then overall size of this button is 500 by 500 pixels. We don't need to make any modification to this button, so we can just lock it. Go to the object menu, lock, selection, and it's locked and cannot be modified as long as we haven't unlocked it. As I said at the beginning of the video, the first thing that I will show you is making a volume level indicator. To create an indicator line around the button, we start by create a short line. Create the line using the line segment tool. Fill the length with 30 pixels and with an angle of 90 degrees. Give it a gray color or a color that matches with the color of the button. After that, open the stroke panel and the control panel overview. Or you can open it in the window menu. Then look for the stroke at the bottom. In the stroke panel, change the weight to 5 pixels and send it to round cap. Now we will place it around the button. In Adobe Illustrator, we have a tool that allows us to make this line circularly around a circle. And this tool is only available if you have the latest version. Let me show you how. Select this line first, then go to the object menu. Repeat and select radial. For now, the result will look like this. This is the same as using the transform tool in the effect menu, but this radial repeat tool specifically functions to duplicate an object radially. And it doesn't stop here. We can modify it again with the help of these three widgets. The top widget is the radius widget, has a function to set the angle and the radius of repetition. You can click and drag freely until you finally determine the angle and the radius of the repetition. On this side, there is a widget with up and down arrow icon. It's the instances widget. Its function is to determine the number of repetition or the number of instances. You can just drag it vertically up or down. Drag it up to increase the number of repetition and drag it down to reduce the number of repetition. Besides that, you can also monitor the number of instances beside the cursor. And at the bottom, there is also a widget. That function is to determine the starting point and the end point of repetition. Or, you can also set it in the control panel overview under the menu bar. This is for the number of instances, and this is for the radius. In addition, you can also use this bounding box to modify its size. You can use the bounding box function only if you want to increase or decrease the size. But if you want to modify the diameter and the instances, you have to use all the three widgets. And let's try to place it around this button. The first thing we have to do is place it in the middle using the align tool horizontally and vertically. one it is in the middle of the button, then we're gonna increase the radius by using the radius widget. Drag it until it's outside the button. For these indicator lines, we just need to increase the radius. And for the angle, try to keep it at 90 degrees. And it's very difficult to set it still at 90 degrees manually like this. The only way to increase the radius and keep it at 90 degrees is by set it in the control panel overview. Here, I fill the radius with 29 and 3. After setting the diameter, we are going to increase the instances by using the instances widget. Drag it until the instances are 12, the same as the number position on the clock. Or, you can specify the amount in the control panel overview. The rest, we just need to determine the start and the end point. Starting point at 8 o'clock, and the end point is at 4 o'clock. And the first step of making this volume indicator element is complete. Next, we just add small lines to get a more detailed impression. But for this step, we just need to duplicate the existing one. Go to the Edit menu. Copy. Back again to the Edit menu. And paste in place. After that, increase the number of instances to 57. And to distinguish it from the previous level line, we have to make it smaller. We don't need to use this bounding box. Moreover, we don't need to use the widgets, because what we will modify is only the lines, not the radial repeat effect. And to edit the line, just double click on it and you'll find the main line. First, change the weight to 3 points. After that, use the direct selection tool to reduce the height. Select the anchor point at the bottom. Drag it up until it's half the height of previous line. Make sure you drag it along the path. The guideline color changes to purple if you are on the right path. Once done, exit the isolation mode by pressing the back button near the selection tool. And done. We just need to add the text min and max. Finally, add a marker line on the button, so we will get the impression of volume control. Next, we're gonna add detailed numeric indicator. The method remains the same as before, by using the radial repeat effect. First of all, create the number using the tool. For now, I'm on the create 000 because we can change it later after we give it a radial repeat effect. First, I change the font type to Montserrat font. And change the size to 16 points. Don't forget to give it the same color as the indicator line. Then go to the object menu. Repeat and radial. Place it in the middle using the align tool horizontally and vertically. Next, we just need to place it next to a larger indicator line using the radius widget. Just drag it until the position is right. After that, we just increase the instances by using this instances widget. Or, we can directly determine the value in the control panel overview at the top. Give a value of 12, equal the number of the large indicator lines. Finally, we just need to determine the starting point and the ending point. After everything is in place, go to the object menu and click the expand. Just click OK, we don't need to change anything here. Now we can change the number one by one, because they are all separated into individual text objects after being expanded. Just use the tool and edit it one by one. You can practice this technique according to what I show you in this tutorial. Or, you can also modify it according to the needs of the design you want to create. You can increase the instances or you can use the other shapes besides the line shape like ones I've created here, such as an indicator with a box or circle shape. And now, we move to the volume controller with a slider fashion. As before, I still use this metal button as the controller, but with a smaller size, 140 by 140 pixels. First, create a rectangle using the rectangle tool. with a size of 1 in 400 by 20 pixels. After that, use the direct selection tool to change the corner to round. Just click and drag one of the corner widgets. Now we have a bar with rounded edges, which we will use as a path of the volume controller. First, remove the stroke by click the stroke box in the toolbar, and click the none button below it, so that the color only has an impact on the fill. Open the gradient panel to give it a gradient color. Click the gradient annotator to apply this gradient to the object. Then double click on one of these color stops to open the swatches panel and pick a color. Pick the dark blue. And for the other color stop, give it a light blue. Or you can use the other colors according to your needs. Now, we're going to give it a shadow on the inside of this volume styler path. But you will not find the inner shadow inside the Illustrator. So we have to outsmart it by giving it an inner glow. To get the same effect as the inner shadow, we have to change the glow color to solid black. Change the blending mode to multiply, opacity to 25%, and blur 5 pixels. Click OK. Now, we are going to give it a tap effect around this volume controller bar, so it has a 3D impression. First, click this controller bar, then go to the object menu, path, and click offset path. Fill the offset with 20 pixels, and click OK. Open the appearance panel. Remove the inner glow effect that is in it by select this inner glow effect. Then click the delete button. Open the gradient panel. Change the angle to 90 degrees. Double click the left color stop and give it a lighter gray color on the swatches. After getting the color, then drag it towards to the center of the annotator. Or an easier way, change the location number to 45%. And for the other color stop, give it a dark gray with location 55%. After that, go to the effect menu. Blur, Gaussian blur. Change the radius to 8 pixels and click OK. The next step is, we're gonna add an indicator lines along this LADALIDI controller. Use the line segment tool to create a vertical line with a size of 10 pixels. Give it a gray color that matches the color of the metal button. Increase the stroke weight to 4 pixels and make it a round cap. To duplicate it along this controller bar, we use the blend tool. But before using the blend tool, let's duplicate this small line first. Press the Alt key on the keyboard, drag and place it on the other end of the path controller. After that, activate the blend tool on the toolbar. Click the first line, then the second line. Double click the blend tool to open the blend option panel. On this blend option panel, change the spacing to specified steps and fill in the value with 30. Click OK. Finally, we just need to add a minimum and maximum sound icon. And we have finished creating the volume controller with this slider version. Next, I'm gonna show you how to create the equalizer slider, but I'll show you in the next video. So don't hesitate to press the subscribe button and the notification bell so you won't miss getting videos that I will upload in the future. Don't forget to like and share. And if you have any question, feel free to ask me in the comment. See you in the next video.